face me, whatever works for you. We are gonna start with some cross knee crunches. So just bend your knees, feet flat to the mat here. Let me get my clock set up. We are going to just roll on back to our spines. You're gonna bring the hands behind the head here. And for the first 30 seconds, we are just gonna do cross knees here. Get this out of the way. So go ahead and begin. We're just gonna reach opposite elbow to opposite knee. Good job. Make sure that you're breathing here. So we're gonna think of this as kind of our warm up. We're just gonna ease into things. Starting to activate through the abdominals. You can take it at your own pace. So let's just continue with these throughout our interval here. You're crossing that middle line of the body. We're gonna go for 10 more seconds. For 3, 2, 1. All right, nice job. Go ahead and stay on your spines. We're gonna warm up more of that outer core down towards the glutes by coming into some bridges. Just bring those arms down by the sides here. On an exhale, you're gonna go ahead and just lift up. Yep, and then bring it down. So think of pressing through your heel. Think of your toes pointing straight ahead. Think of squeezing through the glutes and the backs of the legs as you rise up. And we're still keeping our core in mind here. Breathing in and out. You can even use the arms for help or palms down so we can press into kind of the backs of those shoulders, arm muscles here. We're gonna go for about 10 more seconds. So just think muscle activation here. This is gonna help to prepare us as we progress in our workout today. Go ahead and go for one more. Okay, bring it on down, good job. We're just gonna bring ourselves up here. We're gonna go ahead and kick it up a little bit and get started. We're gonna come into a forearm plank. So spinning around here, I'll be lowered down to my elbows. And we're gonna do kind of a compound movement here. So if you can't do the full elbow plank, that's fine. You can just keep it down to the knees here. We're gonna be transitioning here from our half plank to, I call this dolphin. You're gonna come back down and then you're gonna add a toe tap to each side. So you can always keep it to the knees. Sorry, we've got landscaping going on here. And just move back and forth as well, okay? And let's go. So we're going dolphin,
and we're gonna exhale.
lunge variations. We're just gonna flip over on our side. And we are gonna do some lying side crunches here. So I just kind of set up on my side with my knees bent. Yep, kind of like that, because you know what? You guessed it, we're gonna do those afterwards. So get set up for your lying side crunch here. You can bring your hands behind your head, or some people like to reach out with the right arm. That can be an option too. Just make sure you're not crunching the neck. And let's go ahead and start. So squeezing through those right side abdominals. Make sure you're still breathing. And we're squeezing here as we crunch up. Halfway there. Remember that you can take a slower tempo. You can always pace yourself throughout the time interval. We're going for 3, 2, 1. All right. Stay on your side here. We're just going to hop up a little bit and support ourselves with that bottom arm because we're going to switch into clamshells here. So take your inhale to prepare. As you exhale, we're gonna open that top knee and think of squeezing through that right side, thigh and glute. So working into our more outer core here. So take your time. I really like to take it slow on these. Sometimes I find that the slower you go, it's definitely safer, but it adds a little more resistance, the fact that you have to control it. Think of squeezing at the top here. You're hugging in through your lower abdominals. Think of the source of the movement coming from the abs. Doing good. We've got 15 more seconds to go. So as we finish out for 10 more seconds, looking ahead, we are gonna come into the same sequence on the opposite side. In 3, 2, 1, let's switch it out. So I'm just gonna wind my legs around, or you can flip over. So first we'll start with the lying side crunches. Go ahead and bring your weight down. Set yourself up, hands behind the head for support, and let's go. Think of squeezing and activating the left half of the core as you crunch up. Use your breath for stamina here. Remember, as I always say, it's quality over quantity. Nice, clean repetitions. We don't have to sacrifice proper form for speed or for a higher variation. Knowing that we're all on our fitness journey here, we're gonna build our bodies nice and strong in our own time. We are more than halfway there with our crunches. Just like on the other side, we're gonna follow these up with our clamshells again. We are at the 10-second mark here. Getting closer. For 3, 2, 1, and finish with those. Go ahead and pop up through that right arm. So make sure that shoulder's nice and plugged in here for support. We are gonna get ready for our clamshells on the other side. Take a deep breath and exhale. Let's squeeze open here. So we're still engaging our core for safety and support. As we open up, we're squeezing through left glute and outer thigh here. Totally fine. We are more than halfway through. always take a rest along the way. And I always think clamshells are sneaky because they're always a little bit harder than what they look. We're going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Nice. Okay, we've got one more exercise left, and that's going to incorporate optional the medicine ball. So I've got a 4-pounder here, and Justin's going to demonstrate without the medicine ball. So like I said, these are just great for certain movements, adding resistance. We'll be incorporating them in the future too in our total strength workouts and go over more ways we can use those for strength building as well. So go ahead and set yourself up for a crunch just like we did in the beginning. If you are using the medicine ball, make sure you've got a firm grip. We want to make sure we don't drop it on ourselves here. So we are going to take things right, left, and we're going to reach straight up for 2, okay? So ready? Let's start. It's going to look like this. We're reaching right, left, to the sky for 2. And right. Yeah, perfect. Left. Up. Up. Good. We're going to finish strong. Always take it at your own pace. So again, the medicine ball, it's just helping to add a little more resistance. I'm having to engage a little bit tighter through arms and core to keep it controlled. Right, left, up, up, yep. To the left and up, up. We're going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, great job, everyone. Let's just do a brief cool down if you have some time here. Let's take those legs nice and long out in front of us. Just take a deep inhale. Exhale, we're just gonna walk things forward. So just feel free to relax your core at this point. You guys did awesome. We're going to gently bring our breath and heart rate back down to normal, maybe relaxing through the back of the neck and head a little bit here. And let's walk things back in a little bit. Let's draw in through our left knee. We're going to stretch our abs back out with a gentle twist. So just wrap with your right arm, kickstand with your left. Nice, easy breath. So including a cool down is so important for recovery, for injury prevention. Even if you just take a couple minutes to kind of take a light walk, as I usually mention, we just want to make sure that we're taking care of our bodies so we can keep our fitness journey going and progressing. Let's unwrap. We're just going to open this left knee and come back into a little forward bend. So stretching back out a little bit more through the hips and the glutes here. And if you ever need a recovery day, we have a lot of yoga classes available on our YouTube channel. Particularly the relax and restore classes would be really good to get a really nice stretch if you're ever needing to kind of take a day off and lengthen everything back out. Go ahead and walk things back in. We're gonna pop this knee up, let the leg go long, and then other side, bring your right knee in. Let's start with a twist. So wrap and kickstand. And additionally, we've got some really great meditations as well on the YouTube channel here. Remembering that wellness is holistic. It's mind and body, but it's also so many other aspects. So it's great to, for mental health, to kind of practice some of those meditations as well. Okay, let's unwrap, unwind, open that right knee up, and gently walk it forward. Okay, walking things back in. Just pop that right knee up, right leg long. Go ahead and just shake it out here. And that's all we've got for you today. Thank you so much for joining. Hopefully we'll see you guys next week. Have a great rest of your day and weekend.